Welcome to Down the Road a Piece with Count Duop. This is Joe 24, and we're going to start off today with Paul Bascom Orchestra, Blackout, on States 1952. That was Paul Bascom Orchestra, Blackout, on the States label from 1952. Now, Paul Bascom was born 1912 in Birmingham, Alabama. He did tenor sax work with Erskine Hawkins, also did vocal work as Manhattan Paul. I would like to welcome you to our show, Down the Road a Piece with Count Duop. This is show 24. Well, together, we shall explore and enjoy mostly music that is from 1945 through 1965, mainly Duop, group harmony sounds, with such a blues, jazz, pop, gospel, and novelty added to the mix. My name is Jerry Zwecker, also known as Count Duop on the Internet. Enjoy this show as a two-way conversation in our make-believe living room among friends. The way you can contact me is by email, count-duop@juno.com, count-duop@juno.com. Now I have for you one of the most famous New York groups, the Cadillacs from Harlem, New York. They started 1953 as the Carnations, and the group consisted of Earl Carroll, the lead, Laverne Drake, the bass, Earl Wade, and Charles Brooks. And what I want you to hear today is the Cadillacs, Party for Two, Josie Unreleased. It was put out in 1995. It's probably a 1955 recording.
Let's have a party. you do?
Well, let's have a party, a party for two. You'll get to know me.
No, you do.
Well, bring down that heart of yours. Give my heart a break. Let's have a party, because my heart, it just won't wait. Now let's have a party, oh, a party for two. You'll get to know me.
Know you do.
Oh, life will be so grand. Maybe there's no my hand. You know my love is true, but I just can't live without you.
Well, let's have a party. Party for two. You'll get to know me.
Know you too.
Can't live without you. Let's have a party, oh, a party for two. You'll get to know me.
Know you do.
And I.
Cadillacs, Party for Two, Josie, unreleased, from 1995. Well, now I have a more traditional type of oldie for you, the Bonnevilles, Zuzu, on the Munich label, and later the Barry, recorded 1959, and had a very fine falsetto lead, which was very popular at that time.
Zuzu!
That was the Bonnevilles' Zuzu on the Munich label from 1959. I'm in the mood for some jump blues, so let's go with Calvin Bowes Jr. He was born October 1916 in Trinity County, Texas. He was a trumpeter and a band leader, heavily influenced by Louis Jordan, and he took part in the development of the jump blues style. He also worked with Eddie Vincent and Dinah Washington. What we're going to hear right now is Calvin Bowes, Angel City Blues on Aladdin label from 1950.
Central Avenue and the Sunset Strip, I'll have a lifetime to lose. Those doggone Angel City Blues.
Calvin Bowes Jr., Angel City Blues on the Aladdin label from 1950. I have a nice feature coming up in the second half of the show. Two versions of Castle of Love, different songs, first by the Catalinas and then by the Raiders. Let's make a brief stop in Chicago and hear the Magnificence. They were formed in 1954 and called the Tams. The Magnificent Montague, a DJ, named the group after himself, and the group consists of Johnny Keys, the lead, Thurman Ray Ramsey, Fred Rakestraw, Willie Miles, and Barbara Arrington. And what I wanted to play for you today is The Magnificence, Ozita, on the VJ label from 1958, and it sounds very similar to My Lovin' Baby, the Eldorados on VJ.
D-O.
D-O. Ozita, darling, D-O. Oh, how I love you.
D-O.
Ozita, darling. No one's above you. Ozita, darling. that I saw you. Till I satisfied my soul. And I told you, pretty baby, I told you that love was my goal. I said, darling, I love you. I said, darling, no one's above you.
Johnny Keys and the Magnificents, O Zeta, on the VJ label from 1958. Let's wander back to Brooklyn, New York, and hear the Bob Knight Four, a New York State street corner doo-wop group based in Bedford-Stuyvesant, Brooklyn. They all got together at Franklin K. Lane High School, and the group consisted of Bob Bovino, the lead, and he's from the talent showcase on Star Time on TV back in those days, Ralph Garone, Louis Martino, Joe Napier, and John Roper, their fabulous bass, and Charlie Yucata. Right now, I shall present to you Bob Bovino and the Bob Knight Four, Memories, on the Josie label from 1962. Bovino and the Bob Knight Four, Memories, on the Josie label from 1962. Well, let's mosey on down to Texas and hear Camille Howard, my favorite rhythm and blues pianist, and her real name is Camille Agnes Browning from Galveston, Texas. She was associated with Roy Milton's band, what called the Solid Senders. What we're going to hear today is Camille Howard, You Don't Love Me, on the specialty label from 1948.
Say, except that this is you know well.
Great Camille Howard, You Don't Love Me, on the specialty label from 1948. We are definitely going to relax now with the Larks. They came to New York from Raleigh, North Carolina in 1950, and the group consisted of Eugene Mumford, the lead with the golden voice, Thurman Roof, Alan Bunn, David McNeil, the bass, Raymond Pee-wee Barnes. Well, the song I chose for you today is Eugene Mumford and the Larks, I Don't Believe in Tomorrow, a great song, on the Apollo label from 1951. Now, Alan Bunn does the lead, and Eugene Mumford does the bridge in a high falsetto, as only he can do.
I don't believe tomorrow, I want you to love me tonight. Our dreams may vanish tomorrow, like stars in the dawn's early. Saying, darling, don't delay. Tomorrow is at least 100 years away. I don't believe in tomorrow. I want you to love me tonight.
Eugene Mumford and the Larks, I Don't Believe in Tomorrow, on the Apollo label from 1951. Okay, it's time to put on your dancing shoes. We got Wynonie Blues Harris. He was born 1915 in Omaha, Nebraska, and he's a legendary blues shouter. He worked with guys like Lucky Millinder and other great bands. What I want you to hear today is Wynonie Harris, Wasn't That Good, on the King label from 1953.
Let's play a game called hide go seek. Put your hands over your eyes, please don't peep. You stay here till I find you, and when I find you, I'll tell you what to do. Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? I love to play games with you. Let's play a game called Little Jackie Horner. Go over there and sit in the corner. Gonna stick my finger in the pie. When I pull it out, you'll know the reason why. Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? I love to play games with you. Here's a game called It's Your Time to Sleep. Lay right down and start counting sheep. Close your eyes and relax a while. I'll wake you up and put you back to sleep. Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? I love to play games with you. Here's another game called Kiss in the Dark. Play it in the parlor and not in the park. All you gotta do is turn the lights all out. When the game is over, you'll know what it's all about. Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? I love to play games with you.
Mr. Wynonie Harris, Wasn't That Good, on the King label from 1953. Coming up right now is Nice Ballad for You, Lee Andrews and the Hearts. His real name is Arthur Lee Andrews, born 1936 in Goldsboro, North Carolina. And the group consists of Lee Andrews, Roy Calhoun, Thomas Butch Curry, Ted Weems, and Wendell Calhoun. And what I have now is Lee Andrews and the Hearts, Lonely Room, on the Gowan label from 1958.
In my lonely room, the memories fade like the smoke out of the blue. My darling, tell me, what will I do? Still crying in my lonely room. Do you remember all those things? The things we said before we had to part. And all you left is a broken heart. Still crying in my lonely room. The memories of you keep lingering in my heart. Said we were through right from the start. But I can go on dreaming of you. There's nothing left to do.
Start, but I can go on dreaming of you. me to bear. And when I look, I find no one there. And still crying, beating my lonely road.
That fine ballad was Lee Andrews and the Hearts, Lonely Room, on the Gowan label from 1958. Here is our first record of the Castle of Love set. It's by the Catalinas, also known as the Buddies, from New Haven, Connecticut. They were school chums from Wilbercross High School in New Haven. Now, the group consists of Johnny Luth, the lead, Jimmy Caldwell, Artie DeNicholas, Johnny Kuntz, and Tommy Giuliano. And DeNicholas and Giuliano also are known for starting up the Van Dykes. And what we're going to hear today is the Catalinas' Castle of Love on the little label from 1959.
Do, do, do. Ah.
Come to the castle of love.
Come to the castle, the castle of love.
Come to the castle.
The Catalinas from New Haven, Connecticut, Castle of Love on the little label from 1959. The second Castle of Love is the Raiders from Brooklyn, New York. Happens to be an interracial group, and the group consists of Willie Bobbitt, the lead, Al Hardy, lead and bass, Robert Wallstein, also known as Bob Chance, Leroy Haskins, and Jesse Payton. And what we're going to hear now is the Raiders' Castle of Love on Atco label from 1958.
Castle of Love,
the Castle of Love will be yours till the end. Oh, time I need your love in the Castle of Love.
Castle of Love,
the Castle of Love, we will share every day. Everywhere I need your love in the Castle of Love.
Castle of Loves, that was the Raiders' Castle of Love on ADCO from 1958. Now I'd like to play one of the pioneer groups that performed for 50 years, and I had the pleasure of meeting Carl Jones at the Hall of Fame induction in the 90s in New York. I'll give you a brief history. The Delta Rhythm Boys were formed at Langston University in Oklahoma in 1936. The group was made up of Lee Gaines, the bass, Del Knight, Carl Jones, the lead, Travers Crawford, and Kelsey Farr. And what I'm going to play for you now is the Delta Rhythm Boys, It Had to Be You, on the Festival label from 1957.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who
could make me be true, could make me be blue, and even be glad just to be sad. Thinking of you.
Some others I've seen might never be mean, might never be cross or try to be boss, but they wouldn't do. Oh no, for nobody else gave me a thrill.
With all your faults, I love you still. Oh, baby, it had to be you. Wonderful you. Now I know that it's true. It had to be you. Nobody else. I wandered around and I finally found the somebody who could make me be true, honest, and could make me blue. I'd even be glad just to be sad, thinking of you. Some others I've seen may not ever be me, might never get salty when everything's faulty, but they wouldn't do.
Nobody else gave me a thrill. With all your faults, I love you still.
'Cause you're wonderful, you're marvelous, and baby, it just had to be you.
Carl Jones and the Delta Rhythm Boys, It Had to Be You, on the Festival label from 1957. We're going to make a musical stop in New York. We got the Bop Chords. They started in 1956, singing on the corner of 115th Street. They were influenced by the Willows and the Chords, and they even rehearsed with the Keynotes and the Willows. And they were fortunate to have some great musicians, Mickey Baker and Sam the Man Taylor, when they recorded. The group consisted of Ernest, Ernie Harrison, the lead, originally from New York, William Sheik Daly, originally from Norfolk, Virginia. Then we had Edwards, Skip Orico Boyd, and Morris Mickey Smar, originally from St. Louis. Leon Ivy, the bass, originally from Charleston, South Carolina. Now, this group was best known for "When I Woke Up This Morning, You Were Not There. As I Searched For You, Darling, I Said a Prayer." But what we're going to hear today is Ernest Harrison and the Bopchords, "So Why," on the Holiday label from 1957. Ernest Harrison and the Bopchords, "So Why," on the Holiday label from 1957. It's time to hear a little jazz. That's why I got Billy Eckstein for you. He was born July 1914 in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. A jazz and pop singer, known for his operatic bass, baritone, and rich resonance. He helped shape the future of jazz. And what I have for you right now is Billy Eckstein, "It Ain't Like That," on the National label from 1946.
Got a letter from my baby, said she was coming home to stay. Got a letter from the baby, said she was coming home to stay. But I've gotten wise to all of the fancy lies, and it ain't like that no more. She said she was sorry for all of the wrong she's done. She said that she was sorry for all of the wrong she's done. But I just can't take no more heartaches, 'cause it ain't like that no more. She said how she loved me and would never see another man. She said how she loved me and would never see another man. Though that may be true, but I heard that one too, and it ain't like that.
Just heard Billy Eckstein, It Ain't Like That, on the National label from 1946. Well, I hope you're ready for Billy Ward and the Dominoes, one of the most successful groups of the early 1950s. Billy Ward, the founder, his real name is Robert L. Williams. He was born September 1921 in Savannah, Georgia, and he attended the Juilliard School of Music in New York. Here is a song with the early Dominoes group. Clyde McFadden leading, Charlie White, Joe Lamont, and Bill Brown the bass. And we have Billy Ward and the Dominoes, No Room, on the Federal label from 1952. And the Dominoes, No Room, on the Federal label from 1952. What a gem. Now, their next record is going to be one of those truly great duets with Dinah Washington. She was born Ruth Lee Jones, August 1924, Tuscaloosa, Alabama. She was known as the Queen of the Blues, raised in Chicago. She was known for absolute clarity and bluesy phrasing. And Brooke Benton, his real name is Benjamin Franklin, P.A., was born September 1931, born in Lugoff, South Carolina, and he also sang with the Sandmen on OK and the Golden Gate Quartet. What I want you to listen to today is Dinah Washington and Brooke Benton, Baby, You Got What It Takes, on the Mercury label from January 1960, and they had a terrific arranger and conductor, Belford Hendricks, who did a lot of marvelous arrangements.
Well, now it takes more than a robin to make the weather go, and it takes two lips of fire to melt away the snow.
But it takes two hearts of cooking to make a fire grow, and baby, you've got what it takes.
Oh, yeah.
You know it takes a lot of kissing.
Tell me about it.
To make a romance sweet. Ooh, it takes a lot of loving to make my life complete.
And it takes a lot, woman, to knock me off my feet. And baby, you've got what it takes.
I said,
just what it takes, because it takes more than an effort to stay away from you. It takes more than a lifetime to prove that I'll be true.
What it takes, somebody special to make me say I do.
Oh, yeah.
And baby, hey, you got what it takes.
You know you've got just what it takes, because it, yeah,
takes more,
oh,
you,
yeah,
like in my ahead, spot to get on it.
I like your spot.
To stay away from you.
I can't stay away. Come on, let's do it.
It takes more than a lifetime, Daddy, to prove that I'll be true. Now it's you.
But it takes somebody special,
like me, baby,
to make me say I do.
And baby,
baby,
you've
got what it takes.
Say it again.
Come on, let's do it one more time. All right?
And baby,
baby,
you've got what it takes. One more time, bro.
All right.
The duet, Dinah Washington and Brooke Benton, Baby, You Got What It Takes, on Mercury label from January 1960. Now I got a nice Mary Wells size for you. She was the queen of Motown. She helped to define the sound of Motown. She was born May 1943 in Detroit, Michigan. So what I'm going to play for you is Mary Wells' Free From Your Spell, with the Supremes in the background. And it's on Motown. It was released for the first time 2012, but it's probably recorded in 1964.
Ready, one, two, one, two.
I told myself, you really, really love me. I was so blind.
Jerry Wells, back with the Supremes, Free From Your Spell on Motown, put out 2012. I hope you enjoyed this show, show number 24, and we can do this again real soon. You can contact me at count-doop@juno.com, count-doop@juno.com, and this is Jerry Zwacker. Until the next time.